you see. Right. You've got the drain, which is down here, which should be pretty similar, I would have thought, if you can see it. Just down there, you've got the yellow lever switch.
Yeah.
Obviously, make sure you are draining it for winter. I tend to drain it as I'm travelling home normally.
We do.
And open, and open the taps.
Yeah.
And then all drains out nicely. Mm-hmm. Okay. So you're happy on how to get that water in?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good. Right. So what we got up here is your control panel. If you're aware of the Swift command.
We are.
Have you got the app on your phone? Or?
We've got the app on the phone,
yeah,
yes.
So I can show you how to do that. I'll just going to explain it a bit first though. Okay, so the basics of how to get, when you come in, you obviously need to switch the 12 volts master switch on. Mm-hmm. Okay, what I'll do, it is on at the moment because obviously you can see the lights and everything running. If I just wave my hand in front of it, lights the screen up. That's your master switch there. So that's your 12 volts master switch.
Right.
When you come in, you obviously need to switch that on. You've got menu scroll there, which I'll go for that in a second. Your pump switch.
Right.
Main light switch. So that switches main lights all on and off. Your dimmer lights is the main switch to switch your dimmer lights on and off. Even though you've got individual switches to switch them on. And as I said, another switch for your ordinary light. Okay, so that's the third one. Okay, what's showing on your screen? Dimmer level, because I pressed the dimmer light switch, it's come up there anyway. To change that, if I press the arrow pointing towards the screen, right, if I bring it up to 100, what you've got is above the bed locker and the locker at the front here. So it's 100% now. If I press it again, it'll drop down to 5. So it just keeps going round and round. So if you decide you want it up to 50% or whatever,
right.
If that's not at the bottom and you want to change your dimmer level, just scroll up and down on your menu until you see that on that.
Right.
Okay. What's showing in the middle there is obviously your voltage, your battery. That little L inside the little battery icon, that's to say you're connected on your ledger battery side. You got 240 connected with that little flash there and clock. Obviously clock's incorrect, but I'll show you how to change that because obviously clock is going to be changed hopefully very soon, so we have a bit of a light in the evenings. Right. So you're happy with them bits so far?
Yeah.
Yeah, so 12 volts on, pump, main light, dimmer light, so they're just a switch on. Scroll up and down on your arrows. So the next one we come to is heating settings. So with this clever bits of kit, what you can do, I press the, it's always the arrow pointing towards the screen, mm-hmm. which can change things. So at the moment it says control manual. So what that means is you're controlling your heating from the Aldi heating panel.
Right.
If I wanted to, if I press it again, it says control timer. So I can set a timer on that one now to control that.
Right.
Or app. So you want to control it from your app, it needs to be control app. Okay. So I'll just put it back, revert back to manual for the moment.
Okay.
And then exit settings. Okay, ledger charging. As I said, that's in the centre of that there. No vehicle battery. So if you had the car still connected and you wanted to, you could run the 12 volts from your car if you wanted to. But you go and do that and drain your battery, then you're not going home even if you don't want to. Right, solar panel, you've got a solar panel on the roof.
Right.
That's showing you what voltage it's coming through at the moment, which is about just over 14 volts, charging your battery. Select battery, as I said, if your car was connected, you could select that battery. So if I press the arrow pointing towards it, it's telling me no, you can't, because we haven't got the car attached.
Correct.
Okay. AC limit. So you're aware, obviously, you've been caravanning for a while. Depending on how much electric you use, the bollard on your side can trip.
Yeah.
So if you overdraw the power on that, you obviously you're going to trip it.
Yeah.
Either you're going to go and have to bother the warden to go and trip it back on again, or the possibility if you press this now, you can limit now to 5 amps or up to 16 amps.
So as long as we know what the amp rating is on the on the site, we can set that.
Yeah. So the thing is there now. This is showing me what amperage is going out, okay? Mm-hmm. If it goes above that, so as long as you've got that little icon there showing it is unlocked, I've got it set to 16 at the moment. If it went above 16, what it would do, if you're running power on your heating side of it, so you've got up to 3 kilowatts on that, it will start dropping down the power on that.
All right.
Okay? So it'll drop a kilowatt, another kilowatt. Right. So normally what will happen is if you switch the kettle on or you switch the ring on there or something on electric, hairdryer, it will start shutting down the heating on electric, as long as obviously you're operating on electric. Okay?
Yeah.
Or you can just have it off and just be careful what you're doing, like you've done in
so the past. The heating system is actually powered by electric?
Electric and gas.
And gas,
yeah.
Right, yeah.
Well, I'll come to that in shortly. Internal temperature, what you'll see is it's different showing from there to there.
Mm-hmm.
Thermostat for that one is there. that one is likely to be under that seat.
Right, okay.
Okay, so that's why it's showing variance in temperature. Dimmer level, we did that one. Heating settings, we did that one. System settings, right. You want to change your clock, system settings, press the arrow towards the screen, you can set your hour. So you just got to be careful because it'll just go round and round and round if you keep your finger on the button. What time are we on now?
I think we're 11. About 20 to 12.
Yeah, so press the arrow pointing towards it again, we're set to 11. Press the arrow up or down to find which is your next, which is your minutes. What did we say your minutes was?
I've read about 40, I think.
Right, 40. So press that. This is when you've got to be careful. I tend to, if I'm not concentrating, go flying past it, then you forget that you've got to go all the way around again, which it doesn't take too long. So I wish it was Sunday, but it isn't. It is Friday. The date is the 10th, so we're going to have to go all the way around to do that one. Make sure I'm concentrating on 10th. Month, definitely not November. And then year, 17. Okay?
Yeah.
The next one is key beep on, so every time I press that button, it's going beep. You can turn that off if it really annoys you. Backlight time, as you say, when I woke it up, it goes to sleep after about 30 seconds. You can change the timing on that or have it on continuous. Same with the LED lights. They will go off after a period of time. Tank alarms is off because we haven't got a tank. So obviously this control panel does everything that Swift does.
Yeah.
So it could be a motorhome. You haven't obviously got a tank alarm. Then Bluetooth pair. So if you wanted to connect your phone via Bluetooth, which we'll do shortly, you do it via that. If you have too many appliances, if you want to call them that, phones, iPads, or whatever, too many, you might have to delete it. If you get a new phone, you might have to delete what's on there off to add another one. Okay, and then exit settings. Okay, so that's just that one.
So when you press the top one, that's to exit the settings, is it?
No, you're just going up or down.
Okay.
If I find one that's need to exit settings, so heating. So I'm just going up and down that one now. It says exit settings again. If you want to change anything, press the one pointing towards the screen. That's got us out of there.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Okay, happy with that bit for the second?
Yeah.
I'll just show you your heating, because obviously that, is different than what you had on your previous one. As I said, you can control it from your Swift command side, or you control it manually from what you can see there.
Right.
Okay, so what it's showing on our main screen at the moment, top left, little circular thing, circular icon, that is showing that your heating is being circulated around your van.
Right.
Okay? If it's not there, the heat is not being circulated around your van, so your heating's not on. Top right is showing a little plug. That's to say you've got electric available. It's not running on electric, it's available to use.
Mm.
Okay? So I'll show you how to connect to electric. So underneath here is your consumer unit.
Mm-hmm.
Heating and hot water, electric. That's now off. See on the control panel now, little plug's disappeared.
Right.
See that?
Yeah.
So on the one, you should see there's nothing there. So if you want to operate on electric, you have to switch that one on.
Right.
And you should see it coming back on. All right?
Right. Okay.
Right. And then the next line down, that is your room temperature. Okay?
Right.
So if you want to change anything, obviously first thing, obviously if you want to switch it on, is that one there.
Right.
And green light's showing, indicating it's okay, it's working. Press the menu button if you want to change anything. So press the menu button, temperature. So plus or minus there, maximum 30 degrees.
Right.
If you don't want the heating on, so it's in the summer, you don't want the heating on, all you do is bring that temperature below what the room temperature says. So if I bring it below, say 12, you can't physically switch the heating off if you want water heating. So I bring it to 12 now. Circulation pump's gone off,
right? Right.
So because I set it lower than room temperature, what will happen is when it gets down to that temperature, obviously it allows it to come on. Or if you think, oh, I'm a bit cold, I will increase it.
Back on again.
Okay. The next one along is water heating. That's water heating off. So you can have water heating running if you want, with no water in there either. So you don't have to have water in your hot water tank.
Mm.
You can have the heating running on individually.
Right.
Even though it's one unit, on your previous van, if you heated that boiler with no water in it, you're in trouble.
Correct.
This one, it won't affect it.
Right.
Okay. So water heating, that's water heating normal running.
Right.
Okay, so that's your normal water temperature. Plus button's gone green. If I want to boost the water, press the plus again, full triangle coloured in there. So what that's doing, apart from if you hear that clunk, then it's actually switched the circulation pump off.
Right.
Okay, what it's doing, obviously it doesn't want the heat being drawn away from the boiler. So it's concentrating all the heat on the boiler now for a period of 30 minutes. So say you want to use a shower on board, you want the extra hot water, or you want to do a lot of washing up, you've got extra hot water for a period of 30 minutes,
right,
then it will revert back to normal running. Or you can manually do it by doing that.
Okay.
Then what you should have heard just then,
circulating.
It will allow the heating to come back on again.
Right.
Okay. Energy is the next one. So maximum 3 kilowatts or no electric. That's one on gas. That's gas off. So we've got no energy whatsoever now, so obviously it won't be heating anything up. So if I want to run it, operate it on gas, press that. I want to run it on electric, up to 3 kilowatts.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you can run it on both.
Mm.
So I'll just come back here again so I can see what I'm doing. So in the summer, one, two or three kilowatts is plenty sufficient to heat the water, because you've got 10 litres of water in that tank. In the winter, that system down there will want to heat the whole van as well.
Right.
So 10 litres of water and this van on, say, 2 kilowatts is not really going to happen.
Right.
It's going to give you some warmth, but not perhaps the temperature you want. Okay? So what you can do is put the gas on as well.
Mm.
What it will do is use both energies to get up to temperature.
Mm.
Then it'll shut the gas off and continue ticking over on electric. As long as you keep that door shut and you don't use any hot water. Okay, especially in this weather. If you leave the door wide open, temperature will drop.
And it will fire
the boiler again. Yeah, the boiler will fire the gas up again, get it back up to temperature, then shut the gas side of it off and tick over on electric.
Right.
Okay. Just going back to the AC limit. So if you have got it on electric and then you start burning too much electric by operating other things, obviously it will start knocking down the electric. If you've got gas running alongside it, it knocks down the electric, but the gas will still be operating.
Mm.
So you've still got heating, or because the likelihood of overdrawing the power is going to be winter time or the colder months, because you're going to have everything running. You want the heating running, you want
the
other. So it's probably better to have the gas running alongside it.
Right.
Okay. Happy with that?
Yeah.
There is further menu, but I don't really want to complicate too much.
Right, okay.
It's up to you. I can show you further on if you want to, but there are further menus and further things there which include timers as well.
Right.
So even though you've got a timer on that, you've got a timer on that. There's different timers you want if you want to operate. Also clock setting. The only thing I will show you, if you want to control your heating using this control panel, that has to be ticked there. Third party panel needs to be ticked, which I'll leave it on now. Which will come up on your main screen under A. Activated functions, which is that one there.
Right.
Okay, so if you're wondering what that one, that's what that is.
Right.
Otherwise, if you don't switch that on, it will not communicate from there to there. You won't be able to control it on the heating off your app.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
One thing I will ask you, I won't do it now.
No, go on.
It's quite a while since I've used the gas crossover.
Right, okay.
I just need to refresh my memory on how I get it. Presumably, I've got to switch both tanks on, or else it won't switch over.
Yes, yes.
I then turn it to the one that's going to be first.
Yeah, so your main one, yeah.
So is it on the right or left?
Doesn't make any difference which is your main one.
Right.
Obviously, as long as it's pointing towards that one.
Right.
So you decided, right, this is my main one I'm using.
Right.
This is one's going to be reserve.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
So then you swap to reserve. Then you obviously can change that one.
Yeah.
To any stage.
Yeah. It's a long time since we had to use it. So.
Right. Do you use a lot of gas? Or
Not really.
Do you on rallies and things like where you haven't got electric?
No. You're
not going to be using a lot of electric, I wouldn't have thought.
We're not using a lot of gas at all, really.
No.
Other than we do have an external barbecue.
I could obviously use a little bit of gas, but there again, if you're using a barbecue, you're probably not using the cooker as much.
Yeah, we tend to use the electric because that's already included in the price.
Yeah, exactly. So you're not going to try and use your gas if you can help it, really, are you?
No,
that's fine. My 6 kg gas bottle tends to last the season, to be quite honest.
Yeah.
Because I don't tend to use that much gas. It'll last the season quite easy. If you were going on rallies and things like that where you haven't got electric, obviously you're relying more on gas because you've got to use your fridge.
Yeah.
So you probably, if you're away for a week, you probably last a week.
Yeah, no, we don't.
Yeah. Right. Good. So the next one is. So have you got your phone?
Yes.
Have you got the app?
Yes.
Downloaded. Sure. That's good. I'm not sure you how to connect that. Well, we've got Samsung. That's good. I like Samsung. You got Bluetooth on? Yep.
Bluetooth.
So get your Swift app, wherever you got it.
Wherever it is. I thought I got it on the front.
There it is. That's it. Press on that. that'll think about starting up. So all you do is scroll until you find system settings. So you should only need to do this once. Once it's so press the arrow facing the screen. In. Scroll down to find pairing. There it's done. Bluetooth pair, there we are. Right, Bluetooth pair, has it come that old now? Right. So press the Bluetooth icon in the centre there.
That one.
Yeah, that's it. Think about it. Just press it again. There we go. Right. So to Bluetooth pair, press the arrow pointing again towards the screen. You'll see the light flashing. So if you press search for control panel now. So it's recognising it. Press that one now with the caravan and motor. Hopefully it will connect. It may drop out, which it normally does first time. So we'll get connected first, and then it's bound to drop out. If it lose your signal, if it picks it up in the first place. Obviously it saw it was there. It's just gonna, no. If you just press done, just press search for control panel again. It's still flashing, as long as it, no, it's dropped out. So as long as that is flashing, go again. Right, press that one again. Go on, press it again. There we go. Right, there we're in. Right. Now, fingers crossed it's gonna start, it doesn't drop out again. It's going to stay there. Right. So if you see that down the bottom there, it's got green.
Yeah.
If it's got light lines and a red cross, it's jumped out, it's dropped out. Okay, so you just go through the process of trying to connect again. Right, so what we've got run across the top line, you press that top left, that's your power. There we go. Wait until these icons come clear, which is quite quick, that one. If you want to switch the power off, switch the power button. Might take a few seconds and then everything should go off. There we go.
Excellent. Right.
Yeah. So it says power off.
Yeah.
So press that one back on again. Or you might just wait. All right, just see if it. But you'll see it's also showing your laser battery. Okay. So your laser battery is showing what the voltage is on that. Should be pretty similar to that up there. And what you find is when you turn the power on, the radio comes on. Which is always annoying. Right. Okay. So it does tell you, show you different things. You could put an AC limit on if you wanted to. Live data, obviously we need to connect with the internet, which I'll show you that in a second. So we just press back button now. Next one is water. So we just wait until it shows up clear. Oh, done it. Right. Done. So we just press the icon, Bluetooth icon at the bottom there.
Dropped out, did it?
Yeah, that's it. Search for control panel. See, once you've paired it, look, that should... There we go. Right, just wait for that to come clear. So obviously pump is switched off at the moment.
Right.
Just press that. Obviously you'd have to be very careful in doing that. If you were remote from your van, you go and click that on, and you think, oh, did I shut the taps? Yeah. Water could be going everywhere. Right. Right. Okay, just press back again then. Right, where are we? Next one, heating. Right. So what you can do with the heating, well, I'll just put that to... if you remember, heating settings. One more. App. Let's get out of there. Right. So you see that now? Heating panel's just gone off.
Right.
Okay. What we need to do, what you can do is set. What's happening there? Oh. Just seems to be that over the top of that for some reason. Right. So it should show a timer icon there. So it, you can set a timer for days of the week. What energy and everything else. If, say you've gone walking up the Wrekin, which is that hill over there, if you don't know what the Wrekin is, you've gone for a walk up there, you had a timer set, you're thinking, oh, we're going to be back before that timer kicks in and it's going to be cold. What you can do is override. Override there. And he thinks about it. I see, it just looks a bit funny with the icons the way they are at the moment. What's happening on the phone? Just press back. And go back in it again. That's strange. Right. So I'll go for override again. So we, as obviously waiting for that to think about it. Shows you temperatures inside as well, even the humidity, it will even tell you that. I don't know why it's Problem is with me, I get a bit impatient and start pressing all buttons.
Bit like me.
Yeah, that's the thing. Oh, why is he not doing it now?
Just give it time to work, you keep saying.
Yeah, that's it, yeah, I'm as bad as that. Right, still, well, just let you think about it for a minute. Right, these icons here, see there's like a stop button in the centre of it. That's saying there's nothing operating at the moment.
Right.
See, it's not on. So that one will be heating. So once we get it running, that would show like a little play emblem, like a little arrow or triangle,
right,
to say that is working. Same with that's the water one there. So just go back out of that one for a minute. You know, just one of them things. Just do light. Right. So at the moment, obviously, I've got some lights on. If you just want to, what is it? Oh, I don't know, what is it? It's like it's not fully on the screen for some reason.
To open the app again.
Yeah, just go completely out of it. Just go completely out of it. Just start the app up again. Because I've never seen that one before. Right. Have we still got a signal? No. So we need to get a signal.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay. No,
oh, sorry.
Press that.
Whoops.
Press the little. Just that's it. Press that. Press that again. As your connector's back up again. It's working quite well with connection wise, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just strange that it's showing, it's kind of going over the top of that.
There's a lapse,
see if that. Oh, right, I don't know if you noticed the lights flat. Yeah, I can't see why that's doing that. But so interior lights, what was the other one? Awning light?
Outside.
Think about it now. Has to think too much.
Try turning your phone around, see if it works.
Ah, well, that's brought it up for some reason then. Right, so you've got awning light, dim light one, dim light two. So what you've got is over the bed you've got one dim light,
mm-hmm.
At the front here you've got the other dim light. So you just press one or two, no matter which. Hopefully we can see that light's come on.
Yeah.
Right. So dim two is your front one. Dim one is your back one. You've got sliders here, look.
Yeah.
So dim two, if you just put that to 100%, so you can either tap it there, that's it. As you come up to 100%, just tap it back to 5. That's it.
That's it,
yeah. Yeah, so that's working okay.
Okay.
Dim one, as I said, must be above your bed. Yeah, you just need to switch the dim one on.
Sorry.
Yeah, that's all right. Hang on, just wait till it comes clear now. That's it. Just press that now. So that should be above your bed then.
Above the bed.
Yeah. That's it.
Yeah.
Dim down. Good. Yeah.
I'll just try the awning one again because that was the one that didn't want to play. That's it.
So the awning.
I think it might have been you just pressed a few too many times. It's you kind of going. Don't want like that. Right. So that should say awning on. Yep. Yeah. Awning lights on.
Right.
Okay. Now, so we'll just go back out. Back out. There. We'll just try heating back. Back to heating again. Right. Yeah, so. What's happening with that? Strange, huh? So. Let's even go for override. Here we go. Right. So, with the override, as I said, you've probably already got a timer, or may already have a timer set. So, what you can do is override it. So, I want the heating coming on now. Right. So, you can select gas or electric, 1, 2, or 3.
Mm-hmm.
How long you want it for? An hour. I'm just trying to think now, which one's that with the temperature, that one, I think. Yeah. So what temperature you want to set it at?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll set it at 25. Okay, then start. And fingers crossed, looking at draw panel. Open, there we go. Starting up.
Yeah.
So we've got heating running. If I press that now, look, we set it for 25. We didn't put water on it.
Yeah.
We did 1 kilowatt and gas.
Right.
Okay. So that will do then run for 1 hour, then shut it back down to the timer, whichever the timer was set.
Right, okay.
Okay. So what you've also got, you've got location, but that's coming via the internet. So if we just press that one there. If you can remember, you should have registered with Swift command. You had an email address and a password.
Yeah.
What you need to do is, if you can remember the email address, you can type that in.
Yeah.
In there. And also, obviously, the password underneath that. And there's other things you can
What have you done to me now, love?
I could have just clicked on the thing.
Always fun trying to do these phones. It's such a small key, you can always spend how many times just deleting things. That's it. Just put your password in there then. And we can...
Shouldn't be recording, you put in the password.
No, you shouldn't be recording. No. Right, is that your password now?
Yeah.
Yeah, so just here, press save. Done. So just press done. Then get vehicle details. So that will then recognise your vehicle, or should do. There we go. So that's your caravan, Conqueror, and that was your serial number. Just click, press on that, because you were going to select that vehicle. Just press it again. So. I'll just press save.
Save?
Yeah, yeah. That's it, you selected that, you selected the vehicle, that's it. There we go. I think so. Just press back now. So if we look for a location now, hopefully, locate, so if you've forgotten where you put your van, just get latest, here we go. It's actually at the moment it's showing Hull, I think. Look at Dunswell Road, get latest position. Hopefully it will not pick up Hull. Moment it's not doing that, is it? It may be because we're underneath this shed here.
Okay.
So that may be the reason why.
Okay, we're into that then.
Obviously, signal wise is obviously important. As long as your phone's got a signal,
yeah.
And there's a signal in the area where your caravan is, that will get you that. Okay?
So if somebody's nicked the van, we'll be able to see where it is.
Well, yeah. The other thing is, you just have to go back on your phone. Obviously, there's other things you can get onto the web. Dealer, it should pick up the dealer. So it should pick up us because you're recognised. But yeah, and you could even email Mark Bebb as well. That's fun. Also, history. It will tell you things like how good your leisure battery's been.
If you
haven't charged it for a while, it will recognise that.
Right.
So it can also an engineer can also, if you give them permission, to look at it remotely. So if he's having problems with the van and say, well, this is not working, or well, your battery is below a certain level, that's why that's not coming out. It's usually below, say, 10 volts or something, something may not work. So they could look at that and say, well, your battery's down here somewhere, so that's why it might not be working, or other things, obviously. Okay, just press back, and then back again. So there's lots of wonderful things. On the Swift one, you can see their website or different things. Swift. Talk group, so like a forum thing. Swift TV, where they've got videos of different like new vehicles and whatever, and Swift Connect, which is the one which is connected more or less to what we see as well, which is obviously things like ordering stuff and things like that, which what we do. Okay, and then manual, I think this is that one. The owner's manual can be of considerable size, so you could start. It's obviously recognise what your van is, so you can start open the manual, which is huge. Obviously, you've got that there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or there's a quick start guide as well, but it can take a while for it to upload anyway. And again, you've obviously got to have a decent signal.
Can switch and then the alarm
alert,
on
and that's alerts. That is.
All right.
Yeah. Just click on that. So if you got it set up, just can't try and read from this angle. Alerts disabled. Or you can alarm alerts, frost alerts, tank alerts. Obviously, you haven't got tanks, but it will let you know. Different things if you want to. I think there's anything else. Vehicle battery, so your leisure battery or whatever, if that's dying on you as well, it will let you know. Okay,
we have
you operate it.
All right. Great stuff.
Okay.
Well, yeah. I'm glad that one's actually worked this morning. The other one, we're having all sorts of fun just connecting. It was just
Samsung tend to be quite good at.
Yeah, that's what we found. The iPhone is the one that's not playing nicely at the moment.
I'm a singer.
Right.
And when I had my iPhone, it was a pain.
Yes.
I had to put everything through iTunes.
Yeah.
Well, with this one, as soon as I've got my set sorted, I can just plug this in and...
There you go.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Happy with that?
Yeah.
Right.
So I could connect my phone as well?
Yes.
If we want
you can connect up to, I think it's 5 devices. So if you've got an iPad or iPhone or anything like that, you should be able to connect anything else. Yep. Right, we'll just look at the consumer unit, because this will definitely be different than your last one, I would expect, anyway.